Guten Tag everybody and welcome to CNC Kitchen. In this video I'm finally making something for which my channel name stands for. CNC and Kitchen. We're going to make a beautiful kitchen steak board in the shape of a T-bone steak which involves Fusion 360 CAD and CAM, routing it out, lasering, sanding, oiling and finally trying it out. I call it the T-board. Stay tuned! I downloaded a picture of a T-bone steak and inserted it as a canvas into Fusion 360. The canvas is scaled with a calibration function to the size we later wanted to be. I created a sketch and used the spline function to draw the outline of the steak. I'm making it a little bit bigger, so that the cutting board doesn't get too small. I guess therefore it's technically no T-board anymore and rather a porterhouse board, but well, T-board sounds better. This sketch is extruded to the thickness of the wood board I'll be using. I created an additional sketch where I used the offset function to create a line at the location where later a groove all around the circumference shall be routed. Now let's switch to the CAM module. We'll be doing three operations with three different tools. In the first operation, we'll use a 4mm ball end mill to create a 3mm deep groove all around the board. When you are cutting meats on your board, this groove will prevent the juices from dripping over the edge of the cutting board. In the next operation, the board itself will be routed. I'll be using a 5mm end mill for this operation, which has long enough flutes for the thickness of the board. I'm adding tabs at the base of the board so that it doesn't rattle loose during the finishing cut. In the last step, a fillet will be added to our board. It might not be the perfect tool for that job, but I use a simple countersink for this operation. And we're done! Since my CNC router doesn't have a tool changer, I saved a separate G-code file for each operation so that I can later change the tools manually between each toolpath. Let's go down to my workshop. I've chosen oak for this project because the high tannin content is good against bacteria. At first, I drilled 4 holes in the corners so that I can fix the board to the router's table. I screwed it on the sacrificial MDF board and installed the ball end mill. I manually moved the tool to the zero position and started the first program. I've built this router a couple of years ago when I started getting into electronics. I played around with small stepper motors out of floppy disk drives and then continued and purchased my first real stepper motors. What to do with them? Of course, a CNC router. From the beginning on, I only wanted to use parts which I can cheaply get from the local hardware store. Therefore, the linear guides are, for example, simply heavy-duty drawer slides. The second toolpath uses the long end mill. The tool I'm using is out of high-speed steel, which I usually don't like for woodworking because you can easily ruin them if they get too warm only a single time. The second tool has a different length, why we need to reset the C0 position. I have to pay attention that I don't change the X and Y position because that would ruin the part. The step down is set to 2mm, why it takes 10 passes to chew through the 90mm of material. The lead screws are only 8mm threaded rods, which work quite okay. Due to the low pitch, they kind of limit the feed rates that I can use. I might update them to real lead screws, but I'm not sure at the moment if it's worth the effort. The last tool that I'm using is the countersink. It has a thicker shaft, why I need to change the collet from 6 to 8 millimeters. I'm resetting the Z0 position again and off we go. The construction of the router is all wood, simply because this was and still is the material which is best for me to work with. And there we have it! I'm cutting the tabs with a knife to reduce the risk of damaging the part when breaking it loose. I sanded everything with 180 grit sandpaper and washed it off under running water. This will rise some of the grains on the surface, which are then sanded down again. I repeated this step a second time to get a really nice and smooth surface finish. I couldn't resist marking the board with my laser engraver, which I bought last year from Banggood. You can find a link to it down in the description. If you want to learn more about it, let me know down in the comments and I'll make a video about it. In order to finish the board, I used linseed oil because it is easily available in my local supermarket. There are special cutting board oils available, which are usually made of mineral oil, but linseed oil worked well for me so far. Now to the fun and tasty part. My local butcher did not have any T-bone steak available, so I instead bought a piece of ribeye steak. I put it into a vacuum bag along with olive oil, salt, pepper and herbs and cooked it sous vide to get a perfectly medium steak. After an hour, I put it on my grill for a nice tasty finish. Look at that! Doesn't that look delicious? Thanks for watching, everyone! Please give it a thumbs up if you liked it and consider subscribing. If that made you hungry, please take a look at my second channel, because it did not get the attention yet I was hoping. Thanks for watching, auf Wiedersehen and I'll see you next time!